Yeah, I'm excited about this. Mara, how are you?
I'm fabulous.
You good?
I actually
It's
am.
Good to have you here.
I showered all the way.
Yeah.
That's fucking awesome.
That is awesome.
You usually stop that.
Just a belly button down situation, typically.
Nice.
Wow, and, that's the reverse of a Mexican shower, well, right?
Or a Dominican shower.
Canadian shower?
Well, I don't know.
I already get a Mexican shower. I just need the reverse.
That's jizz, though. That's jizz.
Ew.
Yeah, that's gross.
Sounds sticky.
Your Mexican shower is worse than a Mexican shower.
Sounds spicy.
I like it.
And by the way, if you're offended by that as a Mexican, just call it a Puerto Rican shower. Just flip it on somebody else.
Or Nicaraguan. You can use whatever you want to do.
Guatemalan shower.
Dominican. Guatemalan.
Flip
whatever.
It on somebody else. Polish shower.
Laotian. Shower. Harry, how you doing, baby? You good?
Oh, doing all right. Doing all right. I needed a shower because I was busy trying to keep these gators down.
It is difficult.
I had a tough time doing it.
Were you sweating?
Oh, yeah. It was a lot of work to try
puffing
to keep those gators
puffing
down.
And sweating?
I was out of breath. I was gassed.
Did you get them down?
No. I couldn't keep them down.
Couldn't do it.
Had a tough time doing it.
And my little retarded son got his hair cut today.
Got a haircut.
Because now we got cameras, so he's
got
shit. Nobody gives
angles.
Nobody gives a fuck about your line.
I got an acute hairline right now.
It's crazy how motherfuckers think that something makes a difference.
It makes a difference.
It doesn't.
I didn't notice.
You know, nobody.
I hope your hair fall out.
So, let me talk about my guest today. He's from the UK. I consider him like my new friend. He's like my new friend. I like this guy so much that I feel bad about us winning the war. Beating
Revolutionary
the
Revolutionary War.
Yeah, beating the Redcoats. I feel like we could have worked it out. If it was me and Jeff, we could. Give it up for Jeff Leach, funny dude, biggest comic out in the UK here, all over in New York. Give it up for Jeff Leach, y'all.
Hello, how's it going? I mean, two things. First of all I can think about now through that entire part is Mara's really dirty underboot.
The fact
you only
watched
from the belly button down. Not today, no. The underboot is clean
today.
You missed out. Yeah. Yeah, and I noticed the haircut. I think it looks very sharp.
Thank you.
See,
I like UK.
He's almost like cut the line a little bit, like so it looks a bit like you're receding though. That's the only thing.
No, that's just natural.
Is that natural?
That's just natural.
I got really pronounced like zigzag in my hair as
my
well.
My head is retarded. This side grows backwards.
You see how the dirty English give you a compliment and then fucking shit on you?
Fuck all of England. How about that?
I'm with you. That's why I'm in America.
Very charming Americans with their stupidity.
Yeah. And I like how you describe me as like your new friend. I thought we were actually
friends. We are
friends. I wash all the way every day.
And that's why we're closer.
You need a
Mara.
You need a friend in your life like that.
Oh, we smell like cheese.
So hang on. So wait, I don't understand. Are you two a couple?
No, God, we've covered that in episode 1 to 100.
Oh, okay, all right.
Because I didn't know from some of the chit chat. Young. Mexican Muay Thai fighter.
Why you gotta throw young
okay,
in there?
Right.
Young, why, yeah. Why, what's you trying to say?
That's only what an old woman says.
I know, I'm older than him.
But that doesn't make you old.
It makes
you
feel old.
Yeah, but in spirit, Mara's done a lot of damage. She's got a lot of recon.
Mara's 207 in spirit.
Yeah, I get it. Okay.
Yeah.
She's like an old vampire.
And also, you're dropping like he's a Muay Thai fighter. Like,
yeah.
Why would you
say? Like, we scared
because
him.
Because next
we got
week
guns,
he's fighting maybe. In Queen's Theater. If
oh, he does that for a living?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. Okay.
Yo, he busts his table for a living, but he is a fucking
on the weekend
MMA trying to go. Is he pro yet? No.
Yeah, he's pro.
He's pro.
Look at how angry her face is.
I know.
You take it. Shut up.
He's a bartender.
You're almost British in your approach.
Right. Same thing. I stop trying to, like, there's a hierarchy in a bar. None of you in the bar is doing what you want to do.
No,
so shut up.
Did you hear that Billy Joel song? Nobody wants to be there.
I used to work in a bar. I worked in about 4 bars in my life.
Yeah?
Yeah. I think it's a great place to meet people and to learn about people. It's like an anthropological study in motion.
Yeah. Now, let me say something.
In one type of person.
Sorry, that means the study of people, Dan. Yeah. You look confused when I said anthropological.
No, I wasn't. I know words. It's not Andre. Andre was like, anthropological.
At the Ballada
At the Ballada. Does that, you spell that with an E?
I spell it with a fuck you.
That's how I spell it. That's how you spell it.
I was going to say, out of the five of us in this room, I think you look like the only one who actually has a college education.
Nah, I dropped out.
Oh, okay. All right, okay.
Let's see, that's the thing.
But he's very smart, very well put together. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Looks like an intelligent man.
Just the haircut. Just the haircut.
It's just the look. Yeah, yeah. Just the look.
Smoke and mirrors.
Get into the door and fool him.
We just had him.
And you look a little bit like the guy from the Old Spice adverts.
The what?
Hey, you still look like the Old Spice
dude. The one who rides on the back of that unicorn.
Not Terry Crews, the other dude.
Yeah, the other dude.
No, not the crazy big guy. Yeah. The one who's still ripped, but...
Yeah.
I'll do that shit.
Let's see your winning smile. I know it's a podcast, but they got video. Let's see the award-winning smile. Old Spice.
I got gappies. I got the stray hands in here.
Okay.
All right. Well, good thing your self-esteem is
Madonna had malalignments, and she was.
We all got to have dreams.
Madonna was throwing around pussy on stage.
Yeah, that's true too. She was running around rubbing her crotch on shit.
Yeah, it's hard to pay attention to a gap when there's a fucking seething vagina.
She did a lot to take away the attention from the gap.
Mar, have you got a tattoo of a gun on your finger?
I do. Yeah.
Why are you gangster? I'm confused by this.
No, it's a pun. It's my handgun.
Ah, great pun. All right.
Definitely worth getting on your body for the rest of your life. That was a good one.
I mean, I wouldn't open with it, but it's, you know, it's definitely there if you need it, right?
She also has a hand job. I don't know about that.
Yeah. There's a dick on the other finger.
Pew, pew, pew. Not your best.
But it's not tattooed on me.
Yeah, that's true. You can wash it away. You can forget about that one.
Yeah. That'll come out in the edit. That's never coming out.
I have a camel on my toe also.
Of course you do.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Cool. What other tattoos you got? Any other secrets?
And then I have one that I got when I was 15.
What's that one?
It's a yin yang with sun rays around it.
Wow. Yeah. You were a classy girl.
I was 15.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's not even legal to get a tattoo at 15.
I know, my sister brought me. And then she left me in the room with the dirty tattoo dude with no pants on. And I was like, do you want to come in here? She's like, no, I'll just read it.
Why did he not have pants?
Because I have it right next to
my tattoo. So you got a tattoo of a yin yang when you're 15. You got a gun on your finger. And now you're dating a Mexican Muay Thai fighter who busts tables. Your parents must be so proud of you.
I have my master's also.
I don't know why I'm being mean to you. Oh, you have your master's. In what?
Chemical engineering.
Okay. Why are you doing what you're doing now then? Why don't you go and
did
have a real job?
Did nobody hear Master Harry said in puns?
In puns.
Nice. Shh.
Listen.
I don't know why I'm being so mean tomorrow, by the way. I think she's a very lovely girl.
I know. I just noticed it. We've met before a few times.
I like it.
Yeah. I was being really nice, and then I found out you had a boyfriend. Nah, fuck it.
Is that always the way, Jeff?
Is that always the way? When you're talking to someone, why am I helping you in the elevator? Like, oh well.
She goes, my boyfriend. Boom! I kick her down the stairs. Have your boyfriend come and pick you up with that broken neck, huh?
Anyone got time for that?
Jeff Leach is has beautiful hair. Absolutely. It's a beautiful fucking man. We were at the fucking where was it? We were at Gotham's and
Gotham Comedy Club. Yeah.
Yeah, and what you call it? What the fuck happened? Oh, the two girls, we were doing stand up, and the two chicks came up to Jeff and goes, "Look, I find you really attractive. Let's have a threesome."
Yeah, that was at the Village Underground.
Yeah,
they were very beautiful girls. They were very nice. And then, I had three more shows that night. Two more shows. So I had to take them.
And they came
from. Well, they came in the cab.
Yeah.
And it was great because the one girl was very crazy and she was like on top of me and going, yeah, fucking stick
now, which
your fingers
one was
down
the,
my trousers.
The blonde one?
No, the Brazilian.
The other one?
The one that fizzled out. She fizzled
out.
So she was in the cab doing all that and getting her boobs out and getting the other girl to kiss her boobs while we were all kissing and stuff. It was nice. Then we get to the club, to Gotham. I'm like,
quite lovely. It was quite delightful.
I've
never wanted to bust tables so badly in my life because it would have been done for the evening. Right. But I was like, I got two more shows. I was like, so just watch the show and then we'll go back to mine.
And it just fizzled out.
During the next show, I was so unfunny apparently that she fell asleep practically during the show and her friend had to take her home. No, she was drunk. She was too drunk. I'm going to go home. But then the other girl came back and then we had a lovely evening. So it was good.
I saw you at Cafe Wild with a nice hot piece.
He always gets a hot piece.
She was
I've been doing all right. I think, you know, it is that British thing.
They love it. How does that work in Britain? Not so much?
Just fake an accent. Can you do a British accent? Is he British?
You get so much ass. What? You just don't know. You don't know that women are throwing their vaginas at you.
That's true. I am not good at the tail signs.
Yeah.
You're like Forrest Gump. Yeah, yeah. It was right in front of you all the time.
But yeah, you just shaking hands with Nixon. No idea what the.
I'm getting
fuck
a little better
on.
At the signs now.
Yeah, you should. You've been better. On the show for
a minute.
Yeah, for fuck's sake. I like he acts like I'm getting better at the sign. What's your rate per week now? How many bitches are you bagging a week?
I just like make this a kind of a choose now. I could just like,
right. You know. So he's still like, yeah, I really need to figure it all out.
We'd like to move you up from intern, but you're still a retard.
That's a hell of a performance evaluation.
Well,
you should write that up, make it official, and then ask him to sign
it. File.
You're gonna have to sign that.
Andre
after.
Is a hard worker.
I am. I'll
unfortunately,
try.
He is still a retard.
That's a lot of effort.
Can you sign this? He's like, oh, right, I will put my ex on it. So.
They're so mean to you, Andre.
Yeah,
no, I like you, man. I don't think you're silly. I think you're a bright young man.
Here comes the slam.
I'm waiting for it.
I got to say, also very, very. That was a very hip hop intro.
Yeah, well.
You know, I've been on a few podcasts since I've been here in America. None of them were that energetic.
No.
Or like, yo, what's up? Maybe, I mean, the rest of the podcasts have predominantly been, actually, Race Wars, you know, he's a black man and white guy.
Yeah, Race Wars. Yeah, but we're more hip-hop than
Bobby
Race Wars.
Kelly, oh, yeah, all of them, they were
that's because
they were very white.
Podcast.
They were very white.
Very white.
Intro is like, hey, what's up? Welcome to the podcast.
And ours is fun, see?
And also good, and the best podcast in the world.
Probably the best podcast.
Remains to be seen.
Nah, it's pretty much.
We've got an hour to go.
We've been doing this a while.
And if anybody has anything to say about that, just tell Dante to his face. And we'll see.
Yeah, holla at me when you see me, bitch ass motherfuckers.
You got any negative reviews or some feedback?
I'll unhinge your fucking jaw.
That's how we keep the ratings.
I like that shit.
So, Jeff, what's your relationship history?
You're interested now. You're interested, are you?
I am. That's what the show.
Well, you're dating a Muay Thai fighter, so none of your fucking business. I value my life. Yeah. Now I've already been punched in the face twice since I moved to America. So
really?
Why?
Yeah, and I got arrested as well.
For what?
So I got arrested for. Coming out on top in the fight. But
really?
Yeah, they see in England, this is how it works in England, our police. If there's a fight and there's a couple of guys involved, they'll go, right, bang bang, grab you both, and then they'll talk to witnesses and go, what happened? Who hit who first? What's kicked off here? And based on who attacked who first, the other person, you know, whoever attacked first would get you go, do you want to press any charges? Or they just send you off home, they send you packing.
Right.
In America, it doesn't work like that. In America, they don't do that. They walk over, and whoever looks like they've come off worse, they arrest the other guy.
No,
which
that's
is what happens
that's
to me.
Not happens with me. I get they
well, that's
the
different.
Black dudes get arrested.
Yeah, you just get arrested. Full stop. Sorry,
Dante's crying in the corner, and they still arrest him.
I was like, they beat me and had sex with me, and they were like, "All right, put your hands behind your back."
Seven southern white guys wearing bed sheets with eyes holes cut out, and they still arrest you.
I've never been arrested.
You've never been arrested?
No, it's sketchy.
I mean, professional criminals rarely do get arrested, but...
Yeah. It's because you're good at it.
Not even cuffed or nothing?
I haven't had
no, I've never even been cuffed.
Harry, have you been arrested?
No. No, never been arrested.
Andre?
Yeah, one time.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was fighting and I fucking hit the security guard and I got cuffed.
I too have hit a security guard.
And how the fuck you got to...
Because you got to run.
I didn't do that. I hit him and I kept boxing without him.
Yeah, no, that's the problem.
And he just kept going.
This is why I have never.
He's like, you know what? Now I'm gonna watch a TV.
How do you like that shit? He put on his hat and everything. Like, how do you like that, motherfucker?
Now I'm the security guard.
How you like it when I tell you what to do? Play dress up with him.
Made fun of his Velcro shoes.
Yeah.
Fucking straps
for 47 minutes.
I fucked you up and you have Velcro shoes.
What are those, though?
What are those?
Here's the thing. Anytime I've ever had a fight, even if I knock the guy out, I run like a scared white
woman. I didn't do that. I stuck around because we're British. We go, oh, I'm very sorry about what happened. Yeah, you are. You're going to prison. It was weird. And I had a little bag of mushrooms in my pocket.
Did they get that?
No. Well, they didn't search me. And put me in the back of the ambulance because I was like, I want the other guy to be arrested. He assaulted me. He just punched me in the face. Right. I defended myself. The barman would corroborate that, take some statements.
Uh-huh.
And they were like, oh, fuck. And so they were like, all right. Well, so they had to arrest the other guy as well,
uh-huh.
just because I'd asked.
Because you asked.
Yeah. And then they put me in the back of this ambulance. And then as I was getting out, I was like, oh, I've got mushrooms in my pocket. I'm going to get in so much trouble. So I had my handcuffs behind my back. I managed to pull the bag into my hand as we were getting out.
Wow.
Out of my very skinny jeans, which is harder than it looks.
Yeah. Like, and then that's like Houdini skinny.
I was walking into the hospital, into the A&E entrance, and I just like dropped the bag, you know, behind me as the policeman was slightly ahead of me.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a homeless guy leaning against the wall next to the entrance.
Did he say, hey?
And he was looking directly at me, right? Uh-huh. And he gave me like a little nod as if to say,
I got you.
I saw that. I'm not going to say anything. But you know they're gone in 15 seconds. Right. And I gave him like a little nod back. And I just
went, enjoy.
And then I saw a guy die. Like when I was getting my hand x-rayed because I had like a busted hand from
when
know,
was all this,
defending
by the way?
Myself. And this was a while ago. And there was a guy came in, a homeless guy came in and just died in front of me. They were like pumping his chest and trying to do the old clear and all that stuff. Yeah. So I saw a guy die. So it wasn't a great night.
No, I guess not.
So, you know, fuck America as well. That's how to ingratiate yourself.
He's really a
it?
True American.
That's true.
That's really a true American statement.
That's the truth.
That's how we feel here,
too. I think I'm a true New Yorker already.
Yeah.
Londoners and New Yorkers are very similar. We're very angry people.
Really? London's
yeah, lots
angry.
Of elbows on the subway.
Yeah.
People don't... Like, people look at... If you look at people... There is a sort of what the fuck do you want from me? I just want to smile at you.
I think I want to go to London.
Joy.
I want to go to London.
Exactly.
I think I want to go to London. I don't know if you did any research at all on the show, but it's about
many hours.
It's about relationships.
Yeah.
And his was crazy. Jeff is the pinnacle of, like, Jeff could be on fucking Game of Thrones. Like, he could be on the wall.
Yeah, talk about it in my stand-up, yeah.
Yeah, he could
be... Like a
be
walking, talking human manifestation of a Game of Thrones, of that, spoiler alert.
And women fucking love him.
Do they?
Yeah, you know
Game of Thrones or no Game of Thrones, women are gonna fucking love Jeff.
Yeah.
You almost said Jesus there. And
I didn't.
Well, that's part of it, Jeff. You're like, oh.
Well, that's very sweet of you to say thanks, Mara.
Of course. You're tall. You've got long hair.
You've got to stop flirting with me, though. Seriously, I'm going to get killed. Your boyfriend is going to kill me. I just want it to go on record. I am not instigating any of this. All these
But I will let it happen.
I know
you. Oh, stop. Please, no. Don't grab my penis. No, stop, please. All right. Cheers.
That is exactly how all of my sexual encounters go as well. They're borderline rape, basically.
They just rape
you. Yeah, women trying to rape me. And me, yeah. Like, oh, don't do it. Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to try to. Don't do it. Tally-ho.
Okay. Tally-ho.
That's only if you're doing it on the back of a horse. I think I do okay with women.
No, you do great.
But you know what?
You do great.
I don't know what
Have
I want.
Have you ever been married?
No. I did. I mean, borderline. So I was with a girl for 3.5 years, and that was a very serious relationship. And I sort of had a big step back from my career, and I was bringing up her kids from a previous relationship, which was pretty full on.
How many? How old?
One child, a little girl, from the age of 1.5 to 5.
Okay.
So that was quite serious. That was very serious.
Yeah.
Yeah. But apart from that, I was just a bit of a whore either side of it.
In that situation, you know, you find that you get so attached to the kids that becomes...
I would never date a single mum ever again.
Really?
Yeah. Not because I care about a woman having a child,
right,
but because
right.
I don't want to build a relationship with that child.
With
and
the
then,
kid, yeah.
And then because she literally, the woman is very spiteful. So when we broke up, she went, you're not allowed to speak to the kid anymore. You don't need any contact with her. I was like,
wow.
But she's going to think now two men have fucked off in her life, you know?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
That's it. And I sent
now you know
Christmas
the backstory
presents
of the
got
first
sent
one.
Back to me. Yeah. Which that's retarded as well. Yeah. That's like an Andre move.
Yeah.
Like you could have just like... I'm sorry, Andre.
Shots fired.
I reeled
that
you
was
in.
A good one. That was
I
a good
reeled,
one.
I reeled him
okay.
in.
Okay. That was funny.
He thought I was there for him. I am there for you. But you know, that you just give the kid the presents.
Yeah.
Stay there from someone else. It doesn't matter. Anyway, yeah. But relationship-wise, you think I do well with women, but I'm also in this weird conundrum inside of myself where I'm 31. I do like being in love. Do you know what I mean? And I do like the intimacy and the connection you can have with someone when you're in a proper relationship.
Right.
But I also really love fucking loads of different women.
Yeah. Yeah.
And...
So,
and
in other words, you're
I need a woman
like
who likes
other
to fuck
guys ever.
But that is the
exactly.
But he did really quantify the quintessential experience of being a man, which is it's
sure.
not that we don't give a fuck. We love being in love.
Exactly.
We love doing all that goofy shit, but we also love fucking as many women as possible.
We love doing it with a lot of different women.
So it's never that I don't love you.
And you know what? You know when you see that guy who's like in that relationship and he's like, yeah, you know, I'm really happy, you know, yeah, I haven't cheated. It's like because you can't.
Right.
That's
right,
why. Right, right, right. That's yeah. why. Yeah. If you were infinitely better looking, or you had better fucking game, or you could talk to women properly, or you dressed better, or you didn't like a piece of shit, you would be fucking other women. Sure. That's the reality.
Sure.
For a lot of men. For a lot of men. Well,
because I started talking about this. We don't have the muscle to say no. Like, being able to reject pussy is a muscle that you have to develop with time. Women, they start developing that initially.
Instantly.
But initially,
chemically, women release different chemicals in their brains when they have sex. So, like, physically, a woman has sex with you and feels a connection with you, an emotional or a spiritual connection.
She can't just risk that every time.
And also, a lot of women's sexual pleasure is directly a result of how close they feel to that person or connected they feel to them. Because a man can just fucking come. Like, he just comes. Because
we're also taught that if we sleep around with a lot of people, that we are.
We don't have that thing where we have the practice of saying no. Like, I'm just...
No, but I think we are capable of saying no, but you have to have really invested some time and some effort in that relationship, and you have to really feel like, I don't want to fuck that up.
Here's the thing. You have options of... And I've seen... Every time I've seen you with a chick, you was with some hot chick, right? And... but if she was a pig, you would be like, no, I'm good. You know what I mean? There's a lot of guys who, no?
I'm trying to work it out. Like, I mean, I don't base my, I'm not all about the aesthetic. I do need that mental stimulus. Substance. But you're right. If a girl isn't physically attractive to me, I'm not going to have sex with her.
Yeah. Right.
There was a girl who wanted to go home with me. She was a friend of a friend. She came to the show. I took her to the show. She was hanging out. She's a really cool girl, but I wasn't physically attracted to her.
Right.
And she basically went, oh, can I come back to yours? And I was like, oh, no, I'll just drop you off at the station. Let me get in a cab and drop you off at the station.
But that comes from a situation where you have those options. See?
Yeah, exactly.
See, if you're starving. Like,
there was a time when I was younger where I would have just taken her home and fucked her for the sake of fucking her.
Sure.
And now I'm older and a little bit wiser.
Well, because you've also had the ability to say no. You've had situations where you said that. And that's what I'm saying. It's like when a guy says there's no, I can't get no pussy. Like, it's sort of like when a guy lives by himself and he goes, I have no food, right? And you look in his refrigerator, he has a bottle of water, a bottle of ketchup, some pink medicine, and roach eggs in his that's all
there's
he
no
has.
Food. Now, I have no food.
That's my fridge.
Yeah.
it's so embarrassingly bachelor.
A guy says he's got no food, he ain't fucking around.
Right.
There is no food.
When a woman says there's no men out there, what she is like a kid who lives home with her parents and there's full of food. And he's like, it's just not nothing in here I want to eat. It's nothing I want to eat. You know? And so there's plenty of things to eat, but just not what I want to eat. And that's the kind of the
different
dynamic.
Oh, it's the idea that a woman, any woman pretty much can walk out into the street and just go up to a man and go, do you want to fuck? And there's like a lot of men. I'm in.
Exactly. I don't even like you when I'm in. So and I think that's the difference. Because a lot of times we'll
especially if she asks a black man, because you guys fuck everyone, right? That's why fat girls like you. Isn't that true?
Well, it's we don't really.
I'm just playing up. I'm playing up to the tropes of American comedy.
Well, we know
every black comedian I've seen pretty much goes. You know, we like to fuck fat bitches because we'll fuck anything. Blah blah blah. Keith Robinson. I did.
Let's just say that.
That's right.
Now, man, I like a fat bitch.
I will fuck anything.
Man, if I'm fat, I'm all for bitches.
You gotta be honest.
That bitch stepped on my foot, broke my foot in half, and I broke my foot off
inside of that fat bitch's ass, and it was
song a bitch.
Oh man, oh she was. I was picking up the rose and smelling for the one that smelled like fish.
I was fucking a bitch with a big head, and she was laying on my arm, and my arm went to sleep. I had needles and pins in my hand. I couldn't get her big head off my arm. I had to use a shoe to wedge her head off.
I just want to highlight that. That is definitely not Keith Robinson material. I don't want to slander.
It's just his life.
I don't want to slander the good name. Yeah,
that is his life, though.
That's his conversation around the comedian's table. Not on stage.
Oh, shit. Are you saying something?
Oh, yeah. There was a study on a college campus where an attractive male and attractive female talked to 1,000 people of the opposite sex. They went up and said, will you kiss me? And 89% of the men said yes and kissed the girl.
Right.
Zero.
No.
Women.
Yeah.
Kiss the guy. Now
basically,
one.
Loosen up, chicks. What's wrong?
Pouring
it
on.
Not even the loose ones.
Not even the hoes.
They wanted to just suck somebody's dick. She's like, no, I want to
just wipe it. Not you.
0% is an astounding number to get back.
Zero.
I just want that tote board and the total.
Well, that's the same. That's the same.
Zero.
That's the same percentage of guys that report being beat by their
that's
women.
That's true.
0% of men.
Oh, I saw that when I was walking home from the last time we recorded.
Yeah.
This woman was pushing a stroller and whatever. Some dude was walking next to her and she just stopped the stroller and just went whack and smacked
and
him.
And she smacked the dude.
And I was like, I don't know what to do.
Was that she with the dude?
You should have just slow hand clapped.
They were together. And then I was like, okay, I'm going to go to the other side. And I was like,
For curiosity, what's the makeup of this couple? Like, what's the background age?
Probably early 20s black.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wow, he didn't even ask race, but you threw that in there.
No, that's what I was asking. She knew what I was asking.
They have a synergy here. Yeah. They just know when they're being, racist.
Right, I mean, the only area of American culture that I feel like isn't racist is people fucking. And there's so much racism in New York City.
Everyone
talks about race as well constantly. We don't do that anymore. But when it comes to fucking, there's a lot of beautiful interracial going on.
Yeah, let's not
except
get
in
like
porn.
I'm a racist, but let's you know not what? Be crazy.
In porn, when you look up interracial porn, it's only black and white.
Oh, like, that's not true. I've seen
that's
some
not true.
Asian girls fucked by black guys.
Oh, really?
I've seen lots of Latina girls getting fucked by.
I saw also, like.
You're not looking hard enough.
I don't look hard enough. I actually don't watch porn.
It's true, when they go interracial, they usually, it's not like
a black dude with Tim's on and a white, innocent blonde girl. Oh my God, this is my first time. Yeah.
And she's got
shout out to Byron Bowers for opening that door for me.
I was watching porn and it was this like gangbang porn. Mm-hmm. I was doing it for some research, and it was a little white girl and
as
like
you do.
You were researching what you were going to be doing later on. Is that what it was? That didn't make it sound any better. I was watching this aggressive.
Chef, let's just move on with the story.
This aggressive gangbang porn of this little white girl as research. It was a training video.
Can we move on? So and then
I see what you're saying. Four of us, one of Mara.
Training days originally.
Today's the day.
Oh, okay. Yes.
And then the guys, they're fucking her, and the girl goes, "Give me your nigger dicks." And I'm like,
wow.
Oh my God. That's so racist.
I thought you were going to say that's so hot.
I was like, I'm probably going to finish anyway.
See, I couldn't. I've hooked up with a couple of very beautiful black girls since I moved to New York.
Yeah.
And I could never shout. The female version of that those girls.
Yeah.
Give me your pussy.
Nigger pussy. Nah.
I couldn't do that.
I don't think it fits good. How about black pussy? Would you go black?
And if she said to me, give me that white dick, I think I'd be like, honky dick. It would just be honky. Give me that cracker dick. Actually, that would have been hilarious. You know, I would have found that hilarious.
How about big white dick?
But that's like if you went, that's like saying big black dick. That's okay. Right, right. But if she went like, give me that big cracker dick, I would have laughed. I would have
big impression and given it to her.
And
I would have given it to her.
And it makes it just sound medium size if you say big cracker dick.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
Average. Like, give me that average white penis.
Let me get that Bible belt penis.
Yeah. It's about saying give me that nigger dick is doubling down almost.
Yeah,
like, you're right. When you say give me that, even if you say big cracker dick, you're like, that's like a grande or whatever.
You can get it all the way down without choking.
I can get it down to the balls.
Give me
why
that
not?
Surprisingly above average Caucasian cock.
Give me that
right now. This is the thing though. So I'm intrigued because like, do you think? Now that we're all becoming normalized to interracial relationships,
sure.
I did wonder, actively date long term and not have any cultural differences in a relationship with a girl of a different culture, because I did find cultural differences just in my dating of that of the two black girls. Even,
but do you find the same?
It was cultural... American and it was black. It was American black culture versus white British culture.
Do you find the difference in culture just from being American and being from the UK?
Like
is there a difference
girl.
In that?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. Even in the comedy as well. You know, right, even in the comedy, I said that like there's a big focus on race here, whereas in England we focus on class. So in England, it wouldn't be, oh, it's dating a black girl, or it's dating an Asian girl, or dating a Pakistani girl. It's dating someone from a different class.
Right.
That feels weird, like, oh, okay. Yeah, well, I'm born in the East End, you know, and like in the East End, I would be an ethnic minority there. Right. So hanging around with black people or brown people or whatever is like normal.
That's what you would do.
Yeah, and that's like normal for me. And for a lot of people there, if they go, oh, well, I'm going to date someone from my local area, that makes more sense than dating someone from a posh area.
Well,
do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but it's interesting
because
in
America, there's very clear-cut racial definitions.
In the UK,
black culture,
you have
Latin
gone
culture,
past yeah. that. Like, the historically...
I mean, we haven't. We still
yeah, right, but I'm like saying...
It's still predominantly black people in the lower classes being fucked over by the rich white man.
Right, but they don't call it that. And you know what I'm saying? Like, it could be poor people. Like for instance, here's the thing. Before I met Gina, I'm good friends with Gina Yashire.
All right, I love Gina.
And she's a sweetie. But at first, when I saw her, she didn't really refer to herself as a black woman. She referred to... A lot of British people, black Brits, will refer to themselves as being from the UK or being Brits first before their race.
Well, of course, I think that makes comical sense, though, right? Because that's the most noticeable difference when you get upstage and you open your mouth.
Yeah, but
like,
you don't think of that in terms of when you develop your... And that kind of bothered me that she didn't perceive herself as a black woman... Almost as if, and a lot of times you'll find.
Well, because she's a lesbian, so she's technically probably more a black man, isn't she? she gets more pussy than we do.
Yeah,
that's the reality.
She gets it in.
Actually, that's a lie. She's got a beautiful wife that she.
Oh, she is.
Well, girlfriend, that she's been with long term.
But that kind of bothered me, I think, because I kind of personally.
Yeah, but you can go back to what you talked about, where, you know, when the white people came over and colonized and took over, they took over the land,
right,
and then. When they brought black people over, they weren't given land. So it's a totally different... They're
right,
coming
a different
from a different
situation.
History.
Yeah. Right, plus their history is much more extensive than ours. I mean, you know...
It's much more volatile.
I mean, not only that, but it's only 300 to 500 years.
Yeah, that's true.
And so they've gotten
past a lot of...
They've
already kind of healed a lot of that shit from thousands of years ago. Where we're
I saw Belle.
We're still going through
that. I figured you wouldn't get that. Belle is a movie about a black girl who was adopted by a parliamentary lawyer in kind of like the maybe 1500s.
Okay.
Mm.
And she was like, it was beautiful.
In America?
No, in the UK.
Okay, right. Okay.
And she, you know,
what
this is
year
when...
was this movie?
I don't. It's out now. It's on Netflix.
Who do you think he is? Wikipedia. God, Mara.
Yeah, I do.
Are you pretty good at that stuff?
Yeah, but whatever. It just was a good opportunity for me to tell her to shut the fuck up. But it's like the whole. It's a true story about this black girl who
did they date? Did they date?
She actually marries a this posh guy from a rich family.
Okay.
And she's like beautiful.
Oh, I know the one you're talking about. Belle. Yeah, yeah. And it's all like French Renaissance or Victorian era kind of thing.
Yes, yes.
I remember the poster.
The big dresses
and she's got a lovely pink dress on with white lace trim.
And she's all
sexy girl.
Yeah, you really knew that dress. All right.
White lace trim.
I'm a man with taste. What can you say?
All right, that's where you want to go with. All right. So Dio.
Good interview. Good interview.
All right. Let me throw something else out after. Now we've dealt with race. Done. Tick.
Hold up. What happened was that was dealt with at that time. Like they were dealing with that at that time. Where we haven't even really. We're still dealing with that now. Like what. You know, this internet, like you're saying, it's an issue now. Like even comics and stuff, which we're kind of the you know the philosophers of the time, which is, at least I call myself.
Wow. Philosopher. It makes us sound so regal and
we
good.
We are until we're finger popping somebody in the back of the club. But
hey, Ben Franklin got his share.
What part of Sophie's World did you make it in?
But it's interesting that you know that the UK history has moved far.
Yeah,
beyond
we just got more of it, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, you more time more to kind of deal with it and stuff. I mean, you have a lot of this stuff that's reverting back. Like in Europe, a lot of this stuff is reverting back to the race.
That in America, it feels like it must be more difficult to make an interracial relationship work simply because those cultural identities are so strong here still. Yeah. And it's different if you didn't if you didn't grow up in a black household, or you didn't grow up in a Latino household, or you didn't grow up in a white household.
Right.
You just won't understand different cultural differences, and that can cause cross wires.
England's also a smaller country just physically, so it's you guys have to be on top
it's
of
not
each
a,
other.
It's not a competition, right?
But you guys have to, like, whereas we can just set aside, America's been great at setting aside a piece of property to shove those people we don't want
to
see.
Separate them.
I mean,
our Prime Minister is leading the charge, actually, in Britain. I don't know if you know this. He's leading the charge for interspecies relationship. They found out recently that he fucked a dead pig's head.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's right.
Nice.
As part of his initiation during college.
I mean, in the eye socket, of course, right?
Yeah. It's the only way to do it.
It's not like he's a savage, but yeah.
How fucked up is that? Anyway, sorry.
Andre, white hazing is amazingly homoerotic.
Why so weird, though?
Because I guess when you're on the top of the food chain, you got to find weird ways to degrade people, I guess. I don't know.
I do not want to fall asleep around none of my white friends because they do the weirdest shit.
Yeah, there's like, a lot of balls on chin.
I know we're gonna end the friendship because I'm gonna fuck one of you up.
Yeah, that shaving my eyebrows and face.
Yeah, you don't have any white friends.
I have a lot of them. I do stand up, and then every time I'm around, I'm like,
not friendly acquaintances, colleagues. Do you have like real friends that you like that you hang out with super regularly?
Yeah.
Do you take them around to your mama's house?
No, nobody really come around.
There you go. I think there's like there's a cultural thing of like fear of like. Bringing a different
first,
culture.
I want to deal
in
with
America,
the fact
in America.
That he says he does stand up.
Oh, wow.
I can tell me I can't read, but a motherfucker got jokes.
He does have jokes.
I believe you. You don't need validation from me.
Nah,
I know you're a comedian. Fuck Dante. You see this fucking car? Don't take any badness from this pimp. This 300-pound muscle-bound pimp. He's a fucking riding around in his Batmobile.
We're driving in that right now.
I can't wait. Yeah, it's gonna be good.
Shut up.
He tried to buy the Batmobile, but it
anyone
was not.
Sell it to
yeah, yeah.
They were like, "We're not gonna have you ride around and put on the side Blackmobile." That's what it would be.
You can't
beige mobile.
You can't alter it in any way. And Dante said, "Fuck that."
I'm sorry that I've like taken it to a race place. I'm just intrigued by the world of it. That's what America. But if any of you like seriously dated, obviously you're with a Mexican guy. We should be asking you what you've like.
It's challenging.
It is.
It's really challenging.
In what way? That's interesting. I've never heard you say that.
Because I come from
Michigan.
Yeah, and I didn't have any other race around me at all growing up.
Has he visited?
No.
Yeah,
I don't think they let
Mexicans into Michigan yet.
Especially Mexicans that can do a roundhouse kick.
There is a bill on the House floor, though.
Yeah.
How are you going to make the relationship work when he gets told to leave next year when Trump gets into power?
Yeah, how is that going
to... Are you going to climb the wall to meet him? What's going to happen?
Well, I'll marry him.
I
marry everybody though. So
yeah, yeah. That's true.
I mean,
that's true.
I have been married a few times.
And Jeff was also asking for
himself. Have you really been married a few times?
Jeff was like, well, what's going to happen when he leaves?
I look a bit Mexican.
Yeah, you could pass for El Mariachi sort of thing.
I'm in the gym a lot now. Yeah. So how many times have you been married?
Twice. I've been engaged five
just
times.
Twice.
Just twice.
And you've been engaged more?
Five times, yeah.
Yeah, she.
Jesus
Mara really makes it sound like a trip to Disney World. Like, yeah, I've been there twice.
I went around twice.
Whatever.
Just twice, only
just
twice.
Wow.
Big deal.
Fun rides.
Yeah.
For why? Like, were they old guys about to die?
The first one was old.
Or?
The second one was hot. And then.
Why did you marry the first one?
Third
for the money?
One was just right.
No, I loved him. I was 20. I know.
So that's where you're going wrong.
I know.
Wow.
I didn't love the second one. But he was really.
But if you don't mind me asking, I'm not going to ask your age because it's rude to ask a lady her age. But you're a young woman. You're not like an old chick.
No.
How can you be married twice and engaged five times?
Well, I was done being married at 25.
Have you not thought about maybe seeing a therapist about it?
I see a couple.
Okay, cool. Couple.
Actually, that's why she's here.
I'm not being a dick. I'm like, genuinely, there's like a, maybe you have like a one of those
broken, an addiction, in a
an addiction to to commitment prior to knowing the person properly or feeling like you're in a place where you need to do that.
Well, then Mara compensated for that by being very anti-commitment for a good, a good
I was you for a couple of years.
Imagine if we overlapped.
I know. Yeah, yeah. Wow. It would have been messy.
Jesus Christ. Dante,
and we don't mean
finally,
emotionally.
Dante finally would have got to see that video in real time. Oh, well.
Oh, well. What are you going to do?
So you said it's a bit challenging sometimes.
It is a bit challenging. He's very stereotypical Mexican, where he's very
machismo.
Plays mariachi bands. Yeah. Owns a hat with corks hanging on. Oh, no, that's Australian.
It's a different stereotype.
That's just Saturday night. Yeah, no, yeah. No, he's very much like, you're the woman, these are your woman roles, and then I'm the man.
Which
and
is
you
why she's with him, because she kind of likes the strength of that.
Well, it's you're obviously like a manly man, because he's a fucking he's a professional fighter, and he's... Yeah,
yeah, he's a manly.
Has he ever hit you?
No.
Okay.
No.
Would that be a deal breaker?
Yeah. Well, that I don't was my know. Deal breaker in my first marriage.
Some women who are into like that strong man like would go, you know, he didn't mean to. It's okay.
I've had a girl. I've had a girl say, "You don't beat me anymore."
Anymore?
Yeah.
That's a great love song.
And it's
you don't beat me anymore. Dun, dun, dun.
And I was like, I didn't know I beat you before. Like
that shit rhymed.
Yeah, it was just, it was kind of a weird thing because, you know, we'd have these rough sets.
Drop that beat.
We'd have the rough sets. Oh, man, I almost forgot I had my
I know.
Damn it. God damn it. Where is it at? There it is.
This is a Christian
show. Get your balls back.
There you go.
If for any moment, Jeff, you think that... Mandingo.
There you go.
Wow.
There's something elaborate that Dante doesn't have. He just goes, hold on a minute. I think I got one of those. One time I was on the phone with Dante. He was telling me, this is years ago. He was talking about, he was trying to get dirty with this chick. He goes, I was going to discipline her. Let me see if I have a paddle. I want to go to the store and buy a S&M paddle. He goes, let me see if I have one lying around. And I called him later on. I go, did you find one? He goes, three. He goes, I got three. He got a third string S&M paddle.
Nice.
Dante brought me into a store, God. And we walked in, and he.
You got to say what kind of store it is.
Sex.
The
sex store.
Yeah.
Toy shop.
Oh,
yeah.
Adult toy store.
And the guy was like, Dante.
Like it's Cheers.
Hey,
wow. Dante's here.
Yeah, what's up? Batteries for everybody. Start throwing batteries in.
I found that when I did I guess it's technically interracial dating, it was more off-putting for her than it was for me in a weird way.
So you have to excuse my naivety. What's your racial background?
I'm half Hispanic, half Armenian.
Okay.
But I guess I come across as white or whatever, so a lot of girls think I'm white.
Yeah.
But she was almost more weirded out by it than me. She kept asking me, like, are you sure this is not, like, a thing you're trying to check off your list
or
whatever?
See, that's the worry for a lot of girls.
Really?
Like, no. Yeah, she kept asking me, like, because she's had that in the past.
Oh, where
she had that happen. Yeah, like, she told me she was dating some guy that would keep, like, playing with her hair, like, wanted to touch her hair in a weird way. Yeah. And I'm like...
I do that with Jeff a lot, though.
Yeah, that's
can I touch? Can I just stroke your hair? I want to see what white hair
is
like.
I'm into that interracial shit.
Yeah, and I do it with the back of my hand a lot of times. I was like, so tell me more about Britain.
And I feel like there's some cultures who don't seem to date. I'm talking about England, especially. Okay. When I say Asian, I mean Pakistani, Bangladeshi. But in England, Chinese and Japanese people. Very rarely
will not do it.
Will date anyone outside of their culture.
Well, you know,
whereas in America, it's a bit more likely. I see a lot of hot Asian girls with, well, predominantly geeky looking white guys.
Yeah.
So they're technically still dating as close to an Asian guy as they can.
Yeah. I went to UC San Diego, and that was 90% Asian, and I had no friends other than my crew team. That was
But that's because of your personality. No, that's got nothing to do with your. That was your handgun.
And also your unwillingness to fully shout. Shower also affected it.
Gotcha.
Probably.
Especially after rowing.
Shower.
Cheese on the boot.
A lot of that undersweat from rowing must have
been. I'm just really mad that I didn't get in on that one. Both of you guys beat me on that one. Fuck. Shit. Anyway.
But Asians do sort of tend to, when I went to NYU, they would only hang out with each other.
Yeah.
They're very, I guess, insular, would that be the word for it? Yeah.
Yeah, they're very tribal like that. Like, it was, it's funny, like, now you'll see a guy, you'll see a bunch of young kids, and there'll be an Asian kid and a Spanish kid, and they'll all be
united kind of dependent on that.
Yeah, yeah. And it's like, I never had a fucking Asian friend. You know what I mean? Like, I when I see them all hang out and come to the comedy, I'm like, how did you get that? Like, I didn't ever.
Well, they're brought together by a mutual love or something, obviously, you know, a cultural love, like New York Comic Con, you sort of said that.
Hip-hop is like that. I think hip-hop has kind of blurred those lines a lot where everybody kind of does whatever the fuck they want. They just don't give a fuck at all. You know, and then you'll see a guy, you know, riding skateboards and listening to hip-hop and listening to rock
Asian,
and this.
That's
Crip. Yeah. Asian Crips?
Yeah, I had one in my school, Boo.
We called him,
his name was Boo.
Yeah, you don't
And he was Crip as shit.
Yeah, you don't want
to fuck like,
with that. You don't want to fuck with that.
If
you're an Asian dude
back,
and a Crip, that's not good.
He had no Asian friend. No Asian friends. That's all his friends was just super niggas. Like, super niggas.
Yo, you know what I'm saying, yo. It's my man, yo. I ain't
grown. Yo, Boo. Yeah. That's all you hear, and you just see this big, angry Asian kid.
Yo, what's up? I'm saying.
Yeah. Super blew all niggas. Day. It was the weirdest shit.
I feel like that's a comic book waiting to happen.
Yeah, it was just weird looking at him.
Adventures of Super Niggas. Super Niggas.
Always getting to the
fighting crime if they show up on time.
You fucking did it, yes.
Guys, you gotta be quick.
Hollering at white women from their car. It's the Super Niggas.
It's fucking gotta be really be quick on this fucking thing.
But this is super
missed two shots.
But for me, for my like for my relationship, I don't like white Western women as a general thing. I don't like them. Sorry, I have dated a lot of them. I mean, like, I'm never going to end up with that blonde next door girl, white, American, British, whatever. I like dark women. I like mysterious looking dark women.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. And it's sometimes that's hard because I'm trying. I have to employ a different confidence and a different way of talking.
Now, talk about that. The different confidence.
Well, I think the only reason I was fortunate enough to hook up with those two very attractive black girls, is because I have a black man confidence. That's right. And I describe it as a black man confidence because there's a different way when I see a black guy come to a table and talk to girls.
I don't know what you mean.
Super nigga.
Cool. Yo, I'm saying you bitches do everything together for real.
But there's a dating approach confidence that a black man will have that a white man just doesn't seem to have as a gross generalization.
Sure,
crash
which,
generalization.
And sometimes it scares white women.
Oh, yep, absolutely. Yeah, that's quite intimidating. It makes the fucking fanny gallop as well. They're like, oh my God, this came up to me. So
what's that fanny gallop?
Fanny gallop.
Gallop. Fanny gallop. I'm using that from now on. Fanny. Yo, I like to make bitches fanny gallop.
Yeah. Okay, Keith.
Come on, man.
Come on, man. You gotta make a girl's fanny gallop.
You gotta
song a bitch and make a fanny gallop.
Get the riding crop out and give it a smack on the hide. They like that.
God
you can borrow a paddle from Dante, man.
We got three of them.
I know you got paddles, you piece of shit.
Dante, pick up the phone, motherfucker. Like, hey, I need
Keith,
a paddle.
I'm like, hey, Keith, hi. How it's always great to talk to you. You motherfucker. I'm like,
listen, you big-headed motherfucker, I need a favor from you. Only person insult you and ask for a favor at the same time. Yeah, listen, you bald-headed motherfucker.
This is the best.
Oh, I love Keith Robinson.
Jesus Christ. But yeah, I've it's funny because whenever I've had interracial relationships with women, it really wasn't a problem. I think because I'm like the extreme of that.
You didn't have one that's obviously lasted for huge amounts of time, right? Because you're not in one now. Aren't you?
No, but I've had like 2 years.
Oh, okay.
Two years.
But then this is what I'm saying, though. It hits a point where sometimes I'm posing questions as opposed to making statements.
No,
you know what I mean?
That's fine.
But I do go, I wonder whether it hits a point where you go, God, we are so different in the way that we lived our lives or our upbringing we see family or the roles of men and women in a relationship, et cetera, et cetera. There's so many differences, cultural differences, that sometimes that's hard to get over. You can love someone, you can care about them, you can think they're a great person, but you go, actually, we're in such different places. And it can come late on when you have a kid.
Right.
And then it's like, well, no, this is how we're going to bring up this child and go, well, no, I feel completely differently because of how I was brought up.
That can also happen with class or just...
Absolutely. That's what I'm saying. In Britain, it's class. base. Right.
So it's just something else that piles on the pile.
It's very hard to meet someone that you can actually connect on so many different levels with, which is why I just keep to fucking. Because that's
your reason.
I feel very sad for you, Jeff. It must be very difficult.
It's very difficult.
Hold on, let me pull out my violin.
Oh my God. I can't get out of my bed. It's just pussy all over me. Somebody lift these vaginas off me so I can get up and stand.
Yeah, Jeff should really put on a black turtleneck and write poetry.
Thank God I've stepped out of my... Oops, I slipped on another vagina.
True love will always elude me. But only... I only have this pussy to fall back on. But if only I could find the true love. But alas, I will sit here with my vagina as the sun goes down.
That was beautiful. That's the best impression that anyone's ever done of me as well.
There we go. Fucking Harry's killing it. All right, shut up. Jesus. What I was saying is, like, I always say this, that I'm so not anybody's type. You know what I mean? Like Jeff is a type.
You are someone's type. Look, you're a fucking huge dude. There's a lot of women who like a big fucking dude.
Yeah, but
like,
they don't,
like,
that's not their thing. You know what I'm saying? When they say it on paper, like when a girl goes, what kind of guy you like? And I'm not the guy.
Nobody goes,
I'm the guy that they like once they're fucking with me. Okay. And then they're ruined.
I don't know about the bone sticking out the ear thing, but when I talk to girls now, it's like they have a big criteria of the big flashy nigga with the tattoos and all the gangster shit. Girls go straight to that.
That's not me.
Nah,
of course. What's wrong with you?
Mr. Coy Dante.
But I mean, when you talk about that classic type, yeah. I'm not that classic type. Now, once I get you, right, and said the spider to the fly
into your basement.
Yeah, it's fucking.
It's over.
It's a wrap. And
he's
now
been researching the videos. He's ready.
And yeah. Then she's going. And then when she tries, when those other guys try to, they're like, what do you mean? I can't even lay on your chest. Why? It's like, ew. Like, what the? I mean, I have to have a pillow. I just can't lay on your arm.
You know what I mean?
And then it becomes this thing beyond that. So, what I would say to that, even about the cultural differences. Once you were, if you're exhibiting these, I guess what I call these instinctual cues, these alpha male cues, then a woman will succumb to that. It's amazing to me how much they can change in terms of
their whole thing can be withered away.
Yeah,
there was a woman who's I hooked up with recently who's married. She got married a month ago.
Yeah,
and she was here on her honeymoon.
Right,
we hooked up.
Jesus Christ.
That's just a dirty bitch.
I don't think so. I think it was someone who jumped into something that she actually wasn't ready for. And
yeah, but you know what? To Andre's point, yeah, you're a dirty bitch though. You've had a whole wedding.
Let's not judge her. Oh, right. No.
See, look, this is the thing. That's the slut shaming you're talking about. That is so popular.
No, it's not slut shaming.
It really is.
It's more about you're an asshole for if.
Ah,
even
that's
if
different. Saying you're an asshole for doing it.
Even if you did it in reverse, if you're a dude and you drag a woman and a month in, you're fucking around,
you're an asshole.
I mean, listen, you don't know what that guy went through. Let's be honest,
okay,
you don't know what that guy went through.
I apologize.
You don't know what he was going through at that time, and
she's
maybe,
like, "Where are you going?"
Maybe,
like, fuck that shit.
Maybe he got caught cheating, and then he had to get married to her or something, and then he thought that would work out. Then it would make everything better, and then he was
right,
young
Dante.
And didn't
you're
know
right.
that.
You're right, Dante.
And then he's in a situation where he still has these urges to fuck other people, and so he does. And then all of a sudden, this threesome comes up, and then he can't.
How you find more words to say bullshit with?
I'm listening to you. It's like reading a Mills and Boone novel.
I don't know what that is, but I'm going to laugh with it anyway.
Old school romantic novels with like a man on the front holding a sword.
Oh, yeah.
Like
Fabio bullshit.
Okay, cool. But I mean, yeah.
The lady's secret.
Well, we talked about this, about how once the marriage machine starts, it's hard to get...
Well, you talk about that.
None of us.
Jesus Christ, yeah. You are the oil in that machine. Keeping it well greased.
Here's the thing.
Petroleum,
here's the thing. The type of person
Mara
who goes,
is the slip and slide of that machine.
The type of person who goes willingly through the marriage machine is a person who doesn't can't say no. Well, then it doesn't mean you can go to some dick too. Like if you're saying no, if you can't have it.
Oh,
both
I should
ways.
Highlight. We didn't actually have sex. We just had a little kiss and a fool around.
Oh well.
Finger pop. Finger pop.
No finger pops.
Good fuck.
Still
I'm
dirty bitch.
So
I'm still
disappointed.
Chucking up the dirty bitch.
I'm really disappointed. I'm disappointed in Jeff. Than
I think it's almost more intimate in a lot of ways because there was a lot of conversation. It was a real, you know, real nice evening and passionate
she
kissing.
Really
exactly.
Did she mention why? Which, I mean, she told you the story of her.
Not really. I mean, I said,
she
yeah,
I married him for papers or something.
Yeah, I what I said to her, and she sort of agreed with it. I said, maybe, feel like maybe you're, you know, not in the right thing. And you sort of jumped into it, and you're like, oh, shit.
And here's what's crazy.
Like you said, once the machine starts up and running, it's hard to move away from that. And everyone expects that, and
everyone's got to save the day.
As he makes it clearer to her, that doesn't make him look any less attractive. He's like, wow, he gets me.
He had his.
So it's like even being that kind of guy, because Jeff's a good, like he's a good dude, like. Jeff is just a really kind of friendly dude. And
I'm also not a piece of shit to the girls that I do sleep with. Like, I'm friends with these girls, and I talk.
You're not dishonest with them about what
your
intention is.
No, I'm straight up. Since my last relationship, that bad relationship, I'm sort of over honest, uber honest, which is almost like a blessing and curse. It means that I don't end up in a situation where I'm gonna end up with someone who doesn't know everything that I'm feeling and etc. And I want that from them as well.
Right.
But also, sometimes you've got to keep your mouth shut about shit.
Yeah.
I feel like, and I'm not really doing that.
Everybody doesn't want to know everything.
No,
even when they say I want to know everything.
I think a lot of women are scared of maybe ending up in a relationship with me because, and I know I'm terrified of doing one again.
Right.
Because you know. They go, well, fuck, I mean, like, he's so straight up about stuff, you know.
Is
he really, I don't know.
Yeah, well, I mean,
see that. Don't you notice, like, when girls, they give you this long list of things they want, and then when the list shows up, they're like, and then run.
Yeah.
They just freak out when this shit actually comes to fruition.
His, you know, and I say this all the time. I say, you know, you go.
It was kind of nice.
Which
what was it? Like,
I was impressed. I heard it.
Fruition is a big word.
Fruition is a big word.
Because you like fruit, right? But it don't really deal nothing with fruit. It's completely different.
And
right?
He's back. And he's back.
You feel me?
Fruit.
That's why he's funny.
Fruit-ishin.
Fruit-ishin. Throw that together.
Asshole shit. It's like fruit. he got nothing to do with it, man.
Nothing to do with fruit, nigga. No apples.
You were saying that
I
women.
What I, was saying
no, I think
please
what you were
going
to say, and to that women don't know what they want. Their pussy does.
Their pussy, right? They don't know what they want. Their pussy, and then when they get that, but it. What I was going to say is that when you, as a man, and you live in the moment, like each, you know, like Jeff is a dude, and I'm the same way. It's about my happiness. Like, I want to do what makes me happy.
Men are selfish. We're selfish creatures.
I don't think it's selfish.
Oh, absolutely. I think we're very selfish as a gender.
I think women are just as selfish. Just their needs are different. They make it so that qualifies under okay. Like, it's okay to want a family or blah, blah, blah. Or I want my husband home all the time. I don't want him out. But in a weird way, I don't want him to follow his dreams. It's selfish in a weird way. You know what I'm saying? But it's masqueraded under this.
It's an acceptable form of selfishness.
Right, right, right. Well, here's, and I say, you know, when I came on all those acronyms I do, like, be a better bitch is be a better woman. Like, don't think because you're in a relationship and you've spent time in it that it gives you some kind of tenure or some kind of pension, that if you're working to please me all the time, the guy is gonna wanna marry you. Like, even if you're going, well, I love you and I wanna be with you and you wanna fuck me, and you go, man, you know, I'm kinda really not monogamous. He's like, well, good, we can be together because I want you to fuck other women. You'll be like,
holy
wow,
shit.
Wow, you like a unicorn.
Well, that's what I'm looking for, ideally. I'm not lying. I now have like three friends who have girlfriends who they both like hook out with girls, and they do that together.
Shout out to Kurt Metzger.
Yes, absolutely. Well, that was one of the people I was thinking of. Yeah. But as a particular couple, they're engaged in Romania, right? He owns a big tech company, and his girlfriend is a gorgeous model, and she owns her own company now as well. And they want to have kids one day. They've already talked about when they do that, they'll change the dynamic of their sexual escapades. But they're very happy to, every now and then, they get a girl or a few girls around and they all sort of play together and blah, blah. It's fucking awesome. But they're together. They're in love.
Right.
They're so open and honest with each other. He can say stuff. Like, if they're sat there, he can go, oh, she's cute like that. Or, like, this girl's cute. And she'll be like, yeah, she is. And it's not like, because there's no jealousy.
Yeah.
There's no lies and jealousy in their relationship. So it's so strong.
But
now, that's very rare to find that.
Well, that's what I had with my ex-wife.
Really?
But what happened was, part of it is, it was my fault. Because I went behind and I fucked the chick that one of the chicks that she brought in.
Without your wife being there.
Yeah.
See, that was the selfishness, dude, that's too much. Yeah.
There was a lot of other selfish shit that was going on the other end.
You had your cake. You were eating it. And then you decided that you wanted some more fucking cake on the side.
I was like, I'm going to go eat my cake.
Relationship
and
diabetes.
I don't want you to know. It was just kind of ridiculous. And that's kind of one of the rules about threesomes is that you don't go behind that at all.
And if you're being allowed to do that, man, you fucked that up.
Yeah. And that's why I say that to guys now. A lot of the rules.
Are you still friends?
Yeah, we're pretty cool. I mean, we're not friends, but I mean, she calls me up every once in a while and tells her how I destroyed her life.
Yeah, have you ever admitted it, like you just have on the podcast, that you fucked up?
Yeah. Oh, okay. I do that all the time. I mean, okay. I'm a firm believer that anytime a relationship doesn't work, it is the man's fault.
Well, I think it's both people's fault, you know.
I don't necessarily agree with that because a woman reacts off of you. Like a lot of the attraction, and when these women come up to you, and you know, like the other day when it's a reflection of you. It's your abundance and your openness, and then you're kind of, you know, like you, like just even watching you work, watch you kiss one and then kiss the other one, and it's just they're going, well, he clearly knows what the fuck he's doing.
So
it wasn't a question where they had to feel like where they felt unsafe or that as if you weren't in control, and so. A lot of the things that happened with my marriage was just because I tolerated.
Yeah.
Because I didn't recognize what the root of what was going on, and I didn't set those boundaries. Because I could have stopped it before it got out of hand.
You know I'm charging you by the hour for this as well.
Well, I mean, I actually was helping you because you're the one that doesn't have any real love.
Oh, no. Dude, I was really depressed when I first got over it because I realized my friends were had become my relationship, like my boyfriends and girlfriends. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah. All these amazing friends I had. And when I moved here, I was like, I got none of those. I was like, oh shit, I'm just on my own.
Yeah, but
scary.
You did.
I mean, yeah, you made a few lost times.
I'm all right now.
Yeah, but you're a dude. Like, it just when I met you,
Are you going, Mara?
I have to go to work. Yeah.
You get ready. You got to go and wash the top half.
Before work.
No, I don't wash the top half before work.
This is about to get super hot.
Yeah. When does the
homoerotic? When you leave, we're all just taking our pants off.
Perfect.
Thank God she's gone. Touch my nipples.
I'm not.
All right, I love you guys. Do listener mail.
Later, baby.
Later.
Take care. Lovely
but
to see
the one
you.
Thing you brought up, just the selfishness thing that you brought up, which was interesting.
Yeah.
That story you told about when your ex did actually call you for help.
Yeah.
And she had all this list. Like, what do you think a man should give you?
Right.
What do you think...
Yeah, she was like he doesn't this and he doesn't that and he doesn't do this and it's she called me up about her ex boyfriend and was like, why he doesn't this and she doesn't that and da 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 whatever, and I was like, well, I'm curious, what does he want? And she was like, well, he just likes peace and quiet.
Yeah.
And I go, well, how often do you give him that? And she goes, well, sometimes I'll start to argue and I'll catch myself and she goes, what percentage of those times that he wants peace and quiet, do you give him that? And she was like, maybe like 30%. And I go, yeah, but you want 100% monogamy.
Right? Yeah.
And you don't give but 30% of what he wants. I said, so reality is he should only give you 30% monogamy. So every 3 out of 7 bitches, he shouldn't fuck.
And the rest
of them. And she was like, wow. I probably just need to be by myself. And I go, that's exactly why we're not together now.
But the other thing was, what do you do for him? And she goes, I'm faithful.
Yeah. That was the whole...
There's a whole long list of like what she wanted. The other day, one of my boys was talking
to me about his ex breaking up or whatever. And then he said, why should I be with you? Or like, what's the benefit of being with you? And she was like, you get to be with me.
Right.
That's it.
That's it.
Yeah.
You get to be with me.
And on that note, I go, get out the car.
Well, not anymore.
Get out of my Jeep.
Yeah.
And don't open, don't put, I won't put the
get
step
out of my
down.
Basement. I'm taking those handcuffs off you and you're going to leave right leave away.
It. How dare you?
Yeah. How dare you? And take your paddles with you.
Yeah. And put the lotion back in the bucket. How about that?
So, got a lot of growing up to do.
No,
a lot
dude,
of growing up.
I think we're all just scared of being alone, right?
A little bit.
I like being alone.
Oh.
I like being alone. We're going to do some listen to mail.
Literally,
though.
Mara's walked out and you've put on fucking
I put on some sexy
smooth,
music.
Sexy music. What's going to happen here? I'm terrified now.
We're going to do some listen to mail and answer some questions to help some people, Jeff. Let's get into it.
All right, cool. Let's do this. I have some listen to mail. Yeah. Here. Some stuff from Twitter. which is we've gotten some. This one Mara sent me before she left because, of course, it starts with, "Hi, Mara. I'll start off by saying that I hate it when you're not on the show because you're amazing. The listeners know how to get their letters right to the top. But anyways, I'll keep this short and sweet. My girlfriend is always going crazy because I like girls' photos on Instagram. I would never cheat on her. But hey, I like looking at other women. I can't help it. Am I wrong for this?" This seems like a slam dunk.
I had a chick show to my job holding a picture, a screenshot of a fucking Instagram girl because of the same shit.
Mm-hmm.
"Why you liking this bitch pictures?" I'm like, "Because that's what the app is made for,
that's what
bitch.
It's for. Like, I like the pictures.
I don't even know where the fuck she live. I'm gonna do something."
So what?
Doesn't matter.
You should just tell your girlfriend, just say, "Look, I'll stop looking at them if I'm allowed to touch them instead."
Yeah, yeah.
That's the trade-off.
Double down.
Of course
down.
You should be able to look at photos. You should be able to look at the world. It's ludicrous to try and cauterize someone like
and
that.
And then ultimately she knows already that you want to look at her.
Yeah.
So what she really wants to do is live this lie that you don't find any other woman attractive. And so, look, she's like, "Let me just live in this bubble of a situation where I'm the only person that you ever felt attracted to," which is fucking absurd. I mean, it is called settling. I am
settling
for you. Well,
get the trade-off. Tell your girlfriend to, like, start sending you sexy videos and photos all the time. So if you send me loads of stuff, then I'll...
I think what you have to do is not...
You haven't seen his girlfriend. She might be fucking amazing.
Yeah, but even in that, you know, you get a hot girl for fucking 10 years, she's still, whatever.
Listen, she's asking is for you to kill off or pretend that a part of you, of what you are as a man, doesn't exist.
Absolutely.
And that's an absurd request. It's like, I never want you to look at other girls. It doesn't mean you're going to fuck around on them.
Right.
That's your choice to be monogamous. But that idea, this notion that, and that's where it goes back to the same thing. Their requests are just as selfish, because that's a selfish request.
It's absurd.
But society has deemed that an okay request to make.
Yeah. It's like you're saying to me, "You find other women attractive," as if she doesn't find other men attractive.
Exactly.
Right. And I want you to repress that and act like that's not the case, because it makes me feel uncomfortable. So fuck what you feel. Fuck what you are. Follow this script that I'm writing out that says, you're the only thing for me, when it's not true. And when you make a girl, when a girl feels that comfortable that you're the only person she's attracted
it's
to
over.
You, then she'll dump you because she gets comfortable and she goes, "Why do I even have to work for this? I got him."
Yeah.
So it's kind of human nature to just kind of...
Also when there's no fear of that you're going anywhere.
Yeah.
Like, oh, where's he going to go? It doesn't matter.
Okay, so basically, keep liking the Instagram photos, but maybe a few cat photos in there as well.
Yeah.
I mean,
throw a few cat photos in.
I think you go...
Just to keep it guessing, like someone's dick pic.
I would just go, "Listen, I'm not doing that."
Yeah.
I'm not doing that.
You need a jingle that's something like, "Fuck that bitch, bitch."
I might have that. I might have that. Let me see.
I don't know if we have "fuck that bitch."
Shit, we don't have
"get
fuck
your balls
that
back," though.
We do
super
have that.
Nigga!
Damn it, I don't think we have anything for that.
Do we have "get your balls back," though?
We do have "get your balls back." Hold on. Get your balls
back. There you go. "Get your balls back."
I think I have a "get your balls back" bomb too. Hold on. There you go. The bomb. I think you have to go. No, I'm not. I have this thing that I always say, Jeff. I go RFF. RFF stands for reasonable, fair, and firm. Right. Meaning, is what I'm asking of this woman reasonable, right? Am I firm about what my boundaries are and what makes me happy and setting those boundaries? And is her response to that fair? Is it fair? So is it fair for her to say, is it reasonable for you to find other women attractive? Yeah, that's not something you have any control over. Is it fair for her to ask you not to have those feelings? That's absurd. It's an absurd question to ask. So and I think when guys stop being pussies and they just go, "I'm not going to do that." Okay, so now what are we doing? Are we breaking up because I like other people's Instagram photos? Is this the deal?
So then, if she leaves, then good, because she's a nutcase.
Crazy.
Then you can like all the photos you want to like.
If she doesn't, if she goes, okay, that's wrong. So you win either way.
Right.
But it's sort of like, why give in to that portion of the negotiation? It's terrorism.
All right, and then like, then you'll get a, yeah, it really it's, is. It's pussy yeah. terrorism. Yeah, yes.
And then, they hold, as Patrice said, they hold the pussy hostage, and you have to give in to these absurd demands.
Right.
Like, yeah, fucking around on your girl is, you know, that's it's not unreasonable for her to go, that's wrong.
Yeah.
Like, no one's suggesting you can do what you want when you want, but that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
the thing is, that leads to other things, because if she wins that battle, she keeps going with other nonsense.
Right.
Like, where are you going? Why are you leaving the house at night?
And then she doesn't respect you because you're not standing up for your manhood and not protecting your manhood, and you're discounting your manhood at any cost, which is just not... It just gets to be stupid. Even beyond that, I think... if somebody is going to go, I'm going to break up with you because you like somebody's Instagram photos, then she doesn't really give a fuck about you anyway. So, and I think putting it on the line, like, is this a deal breaker? Like, yeah. I'm not doing it. Okay, now what? What do we do from here?
Cool.
And then what you will find women will do, well, I'm going to like other guys. Yeah, but you, okay. If that's what you want to do, okay, fair. Matter, then yeah. you then it's fake. It comes out of a place.
Right.
It comes out of a tit for tat place where you, that's not really what you want to do. Because if you were already doing that, you would have done that. You know. Because women don't ever not do what the fuck they want to do when they want to do it. They just don't. It's just it's not. In, they don't think in terms of your happiness. They think in terms of their happiness, which is interesting because as men, when you were saying how we're selfish. Men, a man has to put his happiness first, because you don't want to be with a girl that you care about and her be unhappy. So,
well, yeah, you can't be in a good relationship unless you feel good in yourself. That's like,
right,
you know.
Right. And you, I, but as a guy, we go, man. I, part of being a man is like, man, I make this woman happy.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, even though she makes me happy, it goes. You go, man. I make her happy, and she's happy with me, and she's not upset, and whatever. Now there's, I think you have to be strong enough to not allow her to not allow her to like. You have to be strong enough to protect her from her own emotions. That kind of nonsense. Well, don't like anybody. You can't like anybody else. You got to be strong enough as a man to protect the relationship from her nonsense. So she goes, well, if you like Instagram pictures, then I'm gonna break up with you. Like, what is that really what you're gonna do? That's fucking stupid. It's asinine. And you have to go, you have to protect her, protect yourself from her, because she's making these unreasonable demands. So you gotta yeah. do all of it. What's the other one we got?
The other one is Dante, what's the best advice you've ever gotten? What's the best advice you've ever gotten from a woman that didn't benefit other women?
Nothing.
I seen that shit coming.
He did. In all fairness to Dante, tried. I did see him roll his eyes
he's like,
his
maybe?
Head to try to reflect and remember.
Maybe one time?
And he pulled out a zero.
Nah, nothing. I did search. I searched the annals.
What's the best advice you've ever gotten from a woman that didn't benefit? I will say my advice my mom gave me once. It wasn't advice, but it was to go, like, to be more aggressive with this girl I was, like, going out with in high school. She's like,
choke her.
No, she really was like, you gotta really go after the pussy. She literally said that, and I was like, Jesus, mom.
She said, women are abusive. She just said it. She was like, don't let them abuse you. We are
abusive.
That
doesn't benefit other women. That's a pretty good piece of
advice.
She
said, we are abusive.
That's pretty good.
My mom was always very adamant about, like, don't do anything for her that, you know, don't put aside your life for a woman.
My mom and all my sisters were like, you have to be, oh, Dante, be nice. You have to be nice.
Yeah.
So, you have to be nice.
That was counterproductive.
Yeah. Then they dumped me in that vat of awful bitches, and that's why I am the man I am today.
Shout out to Keith Robinson.
Oh, man. Jeff, thanks for coming, man.
No worries. It was an absolute pleasure.
Man, it was a ball.
I feel like we've righted all the wrongs in relationship.
Yes,
history, we try. Past, present, and future.
Until we get another guest.
It's done. Until next show, when you do it all again, but funnier, with a better guest, right?
And no Brits.
Nah, you were fucking awesome. I can't even shit on you about that. You were a great guest.
Thanks, man.
Jeff, what you got going on? Your Twitter? What's your Twitter handle?
Oh, so my Twitter is at Jeff Leach. That's JeffLeach.
Yes, I do have that up.
I'm going to have a new podcast of my own that's going to be launching, which I'm going to obviously get you on as a guest. In the new year with Stand Up NY Labs. It's going to be all about video gaming, actually.
Oh,
it's going to be like Gamer Geek. meets comedy.
Yeah, yeah.
I got a film called London Town, feature film coming out in the new year.
Awesome.
With Jonathan Rhys-Meyers.
Wow.
Directed by Derek Bort. And I'm at the Comedy Cellar every night. All the time. Every night. Come at the Comedy Cellar.
Funny, funny dude, y'all. Check him out.
Come and check
really
me out.
Good
but
dude.
Thanks so much for having me on, man. I really, really enjoyed it.
Yeah, man. I like you pleasure. A lot, man. It's been a short time, but I really like you a lot.
Thank you, brother.
Shout out to Mar Marik. Mar Marik Live. Follow her on. We're going to have that first YouTube episode up.
Should be up by now.
Is it up by now?
It will be up by now. By the time this comes out, sure.
Yeah, it'll be up. Yeah. So, and with videotape and all that, I mean, follow Mara Marik, www.beigephillip.com. All the links are on there. You can follow us. Harry, what's up?
You could always go to my website, ihatecomedy.com, and follow me at Harry Terjanian on Twitter. That's where all my information is. And
that's good.
Yeah, yeah.
Andre?
Yo, follow me on Twitter and Instagram, Andre_D. Thompson.
All right. And you can follow me, everything, at Dante Nero, Instagram, Dante Nero Comedian. BeigePhillip.com. Don't forget to rate and review us on iTunes. Really, 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 really important. Also, if you need a one-on-one consultation, hit me at SaveMeDante@gmail.com. Hit me with that, and then I'll send you the information. We can figure out the phone call and whatever. Also, B-A-B-B, be a better bitch, G-Y-B-B, get your balls back. W-W-D-D, what would Dante do? The Square Pimp Brigade is in the building, and the sexual revolution has been podcasted. We are out, man. I love y'all. Peace.